off the coast of Alaska, the 33-meter fishing boat Destination is heading northwest across the frigid Bering Sea. As Destination travels farther north, the Bering Sea begins to show its teeth.
Picked up out there. I want to take the boys out, check the stacks. I want everything nice and tight.
Yeah, okay, will do.
It's your drop.
Hey, fellas. It's looking a little dodgy out there. Let's get out there and tighten up the stack.
Oh, no, because I had you beat, and you know it.
With the motion of the ocean, the pods will shift, and your chains might loosen up, so you gotta tighten them from time to time. A couple guys will climb up on the stacks, usually with life jackets, and tighten the chains up. Helps the pods from shifting and potentially falling overboard.
Soon, they'll be launching those pots over the side, and the heavy work will begin.
Usually at night or in the morning when they would run to the fishing grounds, Jeff always let the crew sleep so that they were ready to work.
Destination hugs the coast of St. George Island, leaving it behind just before 6 a.m. off the northwest tip called Delnoy Point.
Once you pass Delnoy Point, you're back in the open water.
There's not a whole lot of protection there. The weather can be a little bit more extreme. It can change really quick.
They've weathered this rough patch many times before, but not this time.
Boat from Seattle vanishes in the Bering Sea. Rescue teams searching now for the six crew members.
The Coast Guard has two helicopters searching from the air. They also have two Good Samaritan fishing vessels helping them on the water. But at this hour, still no sign of any of those crew members.
The air and sea search continues for more than 3 days.
Standing next to a phone, waiting for the Coast Guard to call you for any updates, it's unbearable. Probably took 10 years off of my life, you know, that kind of stress and concern for my friends.
Roger, rescue check is complete, ready for one.
I was still hoping and praying that they'd find a life raft, you know, even days after the fact.
Everybody has hope. We're gonna find them just before it gets dark out. We're gonna see a light and all that.
You're still bringing all these scenarios in there, and there's none of them came true.
This sad update on the search for that Seattle crab boat that vanished in Alaska. The Coast Guard called off its search for the Destination last night.
I made it home and I'm safe, and then I heard about this. It's just too close to home.
He's been fishing in Alaska for close to 30 years. Whatever did happen, happened very fast.
The captain and all five crew are presumed dead. It's the worst accident in the Alaska crabbing industry in more than a decade. Almost 5 months after the sinking, when an unidentified wreck is found not far from Destination's last known position. The Coast Guard moves in to investigate.
Okay, here we go.
And launches a video-equipped ROV.
The depth of this mission was beyond our capabilities for diving, so that's why we had to use the ROV.
Petty Officer Adam Harris guides the ROV 78 meters down to the sea floor.
Our hopes were to positively identify that was the fishing vessel Destination, see how many crab pots were on board, how much bait was left, to see how much weight was on that vessel at the time that it went down.
It's proving to be a difficult operation.
There was surface current, and then there was also, once we got below about 100 feet, there was definitely a current that was ripping through down there too.
The ROV struggles forward.
We saw a lot of line. debris. We saw the keel of that boat as we drove up and over it. And we saw the destination on the side.
Destination. This is it.
There's a lot of things that are going through your mind at that time. To see a boat that had such a horrific event happen to it struck a little bit close to home. What happened that day?
5.5 months after the tragedy, destination has been found. Investigators hope it will reveal what sent an experienced captain and crew to the bottom of the Bering Sea. When air temperatures drop below freezing, tiny droplets of cold ocean spray will freeze to a ship's surfaces. Over time, this ice can accumulate.
As the vessel goes through the waves, water droplets fly into the air and then cover anything. The ice will cover the rails, the deck, the crab pots.
Just hours before the sinking, the National Weather Service in Anchorage issued a forecast for the area, warning of freezing spray conditions.
Our current models predict icing conditions, but they don't tell us how much ice actually formed.
To get the data they need, investigators turn to Memorial University in Newfoundland.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Saeed.
Dr. Saeed Dehani is a thermal fluid mechanical engineer who specializes in sea spray icing analysis.
I'll send it to you. You guys see that?
They needed to calculate the potential amount of ice that can be accumulated on that vessel.
In addition to wind, temperature, salt concentration, and wave height, Dehani's model uses a ship's structure, the material it's made of, how it's loaded, and the relative wind direction to calculate the rate of icing.
We calculate ice accumulation at every step of her journey.
They could look at the heading of the boat and the course of the boat and give us an idea of how much ice would accumulate in 15-minute segments.
Using the AIS data from Destination's voyage, Dehani calculates how much icing it was experiencing.
You see, the first part of the voyage, everything was fine.
As the destination enters the final hours of its voyage, ice accumulates.
Wind is boosting icing. Temperature helps icing. The movement of vessel actually increased icing.
In particular, the crab pots collect a lot of ice.
Because of their structure, a stack of crab pots not only collects ice on the outside, it also fills up on the inside.
In the Bering Sea, they often refer to the crab stack as the ice cube tray.
Here, at the time the signal is lost, the ice accumulation is massive.
My calculation shows that destination experienced about 92 to almost 150 tons of ice.
There's a whole bunch of weight you didn't have before, and it's way high up on the vessel. The center of gravity is raised.
With that much weight, she could have gone over in an instant.
Investigators believe icing was the final factor that pushed the already top-heavy destination over the edge.
Then we believe water surmounted the vessel, and then the capsizing began.
They froze up and sank. It was like that. That's so scary.